Okay. Hey, Yampa. Why are you so loud, you mother lover? At last, I've been expecting you to find. You are doubtless overwhelmed, so I will explain things as simply as I can. Why you have a deep voice? That was next, I hear him change it. Let's see if I can do a tough, womanly voice. This is the Temple of Hyla, though it will come to be known as a sealed temple sometime in the future. You stand in the past ages before your own time. Here, the goddess Hyla has only just sealed away demise. A little time has passed since the goddess sent the outcropping of rock into the sky that would one day become a skyloft. Not so good. It is true to its name. You have passed through the gate of time to an era that just. All right. You will have many questions, but for now, you must proceed back through the gate doors behind you. Those? It is there that the person you risked your life and blood to defend waits for you. Okay, cool. And what are you gonna do? Nothing? Alright, cool. Hey, look at your little ninja shoes. Alright, anyway, going upstairs. Hey, look, doors. You come so far, Divine. I'm glad you made it. Oh yeah, I wasn't gonna give you a voice. I didn't really like you. Yeah, okay, I'll give you a voice. I imagine Impa filled you in on everything. We travel very far from home, to the distant past. In this era, the wounds inflicted on the land during the battle between the goddess and the demon king known as the Mayans have not yet healed. Oh, okay. All the fairy tales about that war we heard growing up in Skyloft, incredible as it may seem, they appear to be all too real. Is that a bad thing? I think it's time you learned the whole story. Let me try to explain. No. No, not this music. The old gods created a supreme power that gave anyone who possessed it the ability to shape reality and fulfill any desire. They called it the Triforce. In his thirst to make the world his own, Demise re... What the fork is that word? Redied? What the frunk? A massive army of monsters up for war. He sought to take the Triforce for himself by force. Get it, Triforce? Okay. God is fear for her people. She used her power to send both them and the Triforce into the sky. On a slice of the earth, she cut away from the land. This floating rock became the new home of our people. In time, it became known as Skyloft. Don't care. After a long and fierce battle, the goddess Hylia has succeeded in sealing away demise. No, she didn't. However, soon after the Demon King was imprisoned, it became clear that the seal would not hold long against the fearsome Mother Forker. Hylia has suffered grave injuries in her battle with the Demon King. She knew that if she broke free again, there would be no stopping him. And if the Demon King were to free himself, it would mean the end of the world for all beings for this land. Don't care. In order to put an end to this Demon King, Hyla advised to separate clans and set them both in motion. The only one on this journey was to save you. What the frunk? What's all this crap about saving the earth? Lala? First, she created Fee. She made the spirit that resides in your sword to serve a single purpose to assist her chosen hero on his mission. Her second plan was to abandon her divine from the transfer her soul to the body of a mortal. Oh, okay, cool. She made the sacrifice, as you have likely guessed, so that the supreme power created by the old gods could one day be used as? For a while, the supreme power of the Triforce was created by gods. All over its power can never be ruled by one. I'm not reading you right. I'm sorry. Knowing this power was her last and only hope, the goddess gave up her divine powers in her mortal form. Why? You probably figured it out by now, haven't you, Divine? What? Wait, what is this, the Bible? You are the chosen one. Duh! And I, Zelda, are a bitch, right? I'm the goddess reborn as a mortal. Damn it, I was wrong. The bench? What are you looking at, Impa? The day of the Samurai Girham's tornado tossed me out of the sky and down to the world below. I was only captured by the demonic forces, but I was rescued at the last moment by the old woman who lives in the sealed grounds. How does she know to save you? I had no memory at all of my existence as Hyla and she explained it to me. She helped me remember who I was and what I had to do. I set out to pray at the goddess statues located in each temple across the land. Each statue stirred up memories within me. After I visited them all, Emperor, an agent of the goddess, led me here to the past. Alright, I wasn't letting myself read at all. All of this part of the same great effort to prevent the arrival of demise. I just know I was reading. I was not paying attention at all. Stripped of his true physical form by the seal that binds him, he takes the shape of an abomination. I was going to make a bad joke. But even his hideous state, he's more than capable of devouring this land if we allow him to do what he desires. Why you sad? He must stop him from freeing himself from the seal that imprisons him at any cost. That is why I intend to remain here this time and place to sustain the seal as best as I can. Okay. As long as I continue this vigil, we may be able to prevent the Demon King from fully reviving himself in our own time. Wait a minute. Does that mean that I'm awesome? I knew it. I must maintain the seal that I created so long ago and keep it strong for as long as I am able. With the memories of my former life returned to me, I can see now that this is my purpose. Isn't that kind of... what's the word I'm looking for? Devon, the guy's created Fee and the Great Blade. She's a part of... okay, yeah, don't care. The task of standing against demise in the monstrous form he now assumes rests slowly on your shoulders. Dang. Back in our own time, you've already driven him back into his prison twice now. I can't thank you enough for that. How did you know? Jeez Louises. During your long journey, you've grown smart. Why is Lee looking like that? You learn wisdom from solving devious puzzles. Really? And traps. I did. You gain power by honing and tempering both yourself and your sword. Tempering. Alright, anyway. And by overcoming the trials set before you by the goddess, you found true courage. Yep. Now that those qualities reside in you, you are worthy of wielding the power the old gods have left behind for you. Don't care. Thank you for the Triforce, Bench. Oh, you can... Alright. What, you want to marry me? Alright, sure, I'll get on my knees and everything. Just kidding, fork you. Well, here you have... Yep, don't care. Along your travels, you have found wisdom, power, and courage, and for this, I shall bless your sword with the God's power. May it give you and your sword the strength to drive back the abomination that threatens this land. The mark you see upon the back of your hand is proof that you are the hero of the legend. And that within you dwells a sacred power. It is the mark of the Triforce. Duh. Stand now, Divine. Draw your sword.
What if? I don't want.
Then what? Then what, Bench? I have the power! Alright, I'm sorry. I just want to do it. Did I do that in Wind Waker? Anyway, we now have the True Master Sword. Bright and beautiful. With open wings. Devon, before I say any other word, I feel like I owe you an apology. You see, the mark of the Triforce on your hand is a symbol of the greatest power in this world. Oh, cool. If you can obtain the actual Triforce, we will have the power to vanquish demise once and for all. The problem is, among the countless souls in this world, only a select few, those with an unbreakable spirit, can wield its might. I'm unbreakable? I'm not unbreakable. Wait. It's impossible to know the true reason why the old gods created the Triforce, but I have a theory of my own. The gods created the Triforce, yet they designed it specifically. Okay. Somehow I think that may have been their way of giving hope to all the mortal beings of the land, which brings us back to you. To face demise and give the land hope, the goddess Hylia needed someone with an unbreakable spirit that someone is you, Divine. Well then, I am pretty awesome. But spirit alone wasn't enough. You had to overcome many trials and awaken the hero within yourself. so that you could wield that supreme power. And so, I... Ah, blasphemy! That's what I was thinking of. I knew that if it meant saving Zelda, you would throw yourself head first into any danger, without even a moment's doubt. I used you. You dick! I can't begin to tell you how sorry I am for pulling you into all this, Divine. Fork you! But you have to understand, this is a war, and the fate of the land hangs in a balance. I need your strength to tip the scales in our favor. Okay. Wait. All is fair in love and war? That sucks. All that may be well intended and true, but it doesn't mean it's right, and it doesn't excuse my actions. But I am prepared to pay the price for what I've done. What'd you do? I'm just kidding, you suck, you stupid bat. To ensure that the seal holds, I will remain here in this time, deep in sleep for thousands of years. Oh, wow. Divine, I can't say it enough. I'm so sorry for the way I had to involve you in all this. Man. But until my memory of things before our lifetime returned, I had no idea we were fated to carry such a heavy destiny. Before all this, I was happy just spending my days hanging around with you and Skylock. I wanted that feeling to last forever. Is that what you want to say? Wait a minute, that's not fair. It's just not fair. While it's true that I am highly born, I'm still my father's daughter and your friend. Fork you! I'm still your Zelda. Shut up, bitch. Come back to me. When Demise is finally gone, there will be no more need for the seal that binds him, and then I'll be able to wake up. So I'm going to ask you a favor, sleepyhead. No, you didn't. Ever since we were kids, I'd always been the one to wake you up when you slept in. But this time, when all this is over, will you come wake me up? Oh, I can't be a dick? Alright, fine. I promise. No! Don't cry, dude. Don't cry. Link, don't cry. Dude, don't cry. Aww. He shed a tear. The only girl you ever loved, dude. Since I have a amber crystal floating in the thin air. Oh well. Dude, life goes on. Hey, Impa. That girl there is kind of a douche. You can have her. It's done. I need water.